I really didn't know anything about Stanford coming in. I'm really lucky that I just happened to fall into such an amazing place. I showed up on day one and it was like exactly 70 degrees, a couple pretty clouds in the sky, and your RAs shout your name. They're like, "Welcome, Mary." And I was like, "How do they know who I am?" Like, I was like looking back around, like, me, like this Mary, you know? It was just like this overwhelmingly welcome, enthusiastic environment. And I remember thinking, like, I made the right decision and I chose like the best school for me. Hi, I'm Mary Cooper. I'm a senior majoring in aerospace engineering and computer science, and I'll be graduating this June with the class of 2022. So my dad's a helicopter pilot in the US Coast Guard. He's like actually a certified badass. He's so cool. He's been probably like my hero forever, but his job kind of like requires us to move around quite a bit. We moved about 8 or 9 different times as I was a kid, and I ended up going to 4 different high schools. Growing up as a military brat, sports has always been like a huge part of my life. Especially moving around, it really helped me make friends and find my community wherever we live. When I came to Stanford, I kind of used that same mindset. The rowing team is like the main Division I team that takes on walk-ons, and I was like, if we're gonna join a team, might as well like go big or go home. I remember just a big sense of pride as a team and feeling like accepted, especially as a disabled athlete and one of the first para-athletes at Stanford. I didn't really know what I was getting myself into. My teammates have always just looked at me like I was anyone else, and they've treated me with respect and dignity, and I'm really grateful for that. I'm a below-the-knee amputee. I was actually born sick, and I ended up having my leg amputated when I was around a year old. So really, I've just grown up with a prosthetic leg. It's all I've ever known. To me, my disability is like part of the reason I study engineering here at Stanford. Tinkering with my prosthetic legs growing up, duct taping the toes when they fall off, whatever it might be, was always kind of like leading me towards a problem-solving mindset, or kind of like that natural engineering mindset. So I designed a major that's called Aerospace Engineering and Computer Science, and I've been really lucky to be part of an organization called Mission Astro Access. I had the chance to go on a zero-G parabolic flight, which was very exciting, and research accessible spaceflight solutions. My ultimate goal is to be an astronaut, which would be amazing. What excites me most about space is just kind of that it's the next frontier in my mind. Like, there's still so much that we don't know, and that's what keeps me like passionate about it every day. I think it's really been waves this senior spring. Obviously, I spend a lot of time with my friends, and I think all the time we're like counting down the days we have left, and it just doesn't feel real. I don't know if it will honestly feel real until I'm like in my cap and gown walking through Stanford Stadium getting my diploma. I don't want it to feel real until then, I think. I tend to get new legs like every 3 or 4 years, and so that obviously is about a cycle as a Stanford undergrad. And so I have one leg that I've been using basically since freshman year up until now. Actually, when I found out I got into Stanford, the people that make my leg, they're called prosthetists, they had made the inside of that leg cardinal red, which was really nice of them. I would really like to get that leg into the time capsule. I think it would be a really neat little memento to really represent my time here at Stanford and all the miles I walked.